Well, it's going to be hot, just like it was this 4th of July weekend. We're going to see that those temperatures absolutely sweltering by the time we get into the afternoon. We'll see that those highs top out at that century mark. But as we roll on throughout the rest of your week, this first week of July, we're not getting anything different. Rain-free conditions with those temperatures above the century mark each and every day. And with the feels like added on, it's actually going to feel a couple of degrees warmer. So rain-free is exactly what we're seeing as we take that look over Texas for the most part. And once we take that zoom into central Texas, look at this. It is quiet as a peep, not seeing any cloud coverage, but all of that moisture coming in from the Gulf making for some of those humid conditions. As you take it outside of downtown Temple right now, sun is up and it's actually a beautiful look right now, 75 degrees with that wind just slightly at 8 miles per hour. But as we get on throughout the rest of the day, we could see gusts get up to 20 miles per hour and we could really use that breeze to provide us a little bit of relief from this summer heat. Now these are what those temperatures are right now because of that humidity. If you're waking up in Waco, it's already feeling like the 80 degree mark, as well as in College Station. The rest of us feeling like those mid to upper 70s. And as you get out and go into the Belt and Parade, expect it to be a hot one. Want to find ways to stay cool? Really, any of those outdoor plans you have on this July 4th. By the time the parade gets up and going, we're going to see that those temperatures in the upper 80s. And as the day rolls on, we'll see that we'll top out at that century mark. But again, because of the humidity, it's going to actually feel a couple of degrees warmer out there. So needless to say, beating the heat going to be very, very essential for any of those July 4th plans you have outdoors today. Even as you go to those fireworks shows tonight, because we're going to get those clouds on the increase, and it's actually going to make for some muggy conditions with those temperatures only topping out into the lower 90s as you're outside. So a nice snow cone, maybe even some extra water, going to be very, very vital even as you go to those fireworks shows later today. And it's also going to be humid, so keep in mind, because of the humidity, some of those fireworks you see may be a little less bright. We'll have a little bit of calmer winds as well, which is going to be a little bit harder for that smoke to burn out. But as I've been saying, beating the heat going to be essential for this July 4th holiday, but it's also going to be essential as you go back to work tomorrow. And as we continue on throughout the rest of this work week, we're going to see plenty of sunshine with temperatures the hottest by the time we get into your Wednesday. And that's because that high pressure is going to move closer to us by then, and that's going to bump the feels like temperatures up a couple of degrees too. And we could see a heat advisory get issued by the time this middle of the week is all said and done. So those are the criteria that we have to meet, and it does look like as of right now that we are going to meet that. So that summer like heat is in full effect this first week of July. Jasmine, going to want to find ways to stay cool.